Over near the Parthenon, you may have heard him before you actually saw him, a man standing alone playing his saxophone. News Channel 5's Chris Davis and photojournalist Jordan Powell discovered when he performs, he is sharing a lot more than just his music.
In America's music city, it isn't hard to find a musician. When just about anywhere can be turned into a stage. But in a town with this many musicians, it is a big deal.
I'm like, oh my gosh, I know this song.
When you can get people to stop.
I think he's amazing.
And listen.
I heard him all the way over there and we walked all the way around and listened to him.
Accompanied by just an iPad and a small speaker, Jermaine Pitt spends a lot of his evenings here delighting crowds.
Woo!
Thank you.
But he'll be the first to admit that's not why he does it.
I'm going to be selfish and say it's more therapy for me than it is for anybody else.
Like a lot of Americans, Jermaine's life sounded sweet until a minor cord of COVID-19 caused major mental health problems.
Extremely happy, full of energy, to just literally not wanting to live anymore because I couldn't interact with other people. I started performing poorly at work, started drinking more. I mean, we're in Nashville. That's just what happens. And it literally got to the point where I didn't want to wake up anymore. When I went to sleep at night, I prayed that I wouldn't wake up. And so I woke up one day and I went to my doctor and she said, you have to go get help because you might not be here very much longer.
What do you think we ought to mess around with this evening?
So a few months back, he started attending regular therapy sessions with Claudine Jefferson.
I think we need to mess around with scatterbrained today because I'm really scatterbrained.
That's when Jermaine realized some of these issues may have just surfaced, but they've been plaguing him for years.
You know, all this trauma that I have, all the problems that I'm dealing with, they all start with my biological mother, my biological father, mm-hmm. my adopted mother, and my adopted father.
Mm-hmm. So he decided to do inpatient rehab, commit to regular therapy, and at the suggestion of his therapist.
See, music had charm to soothe the savage beast.
Find some blessed assurances through his own talents. In addition to busking for occasional tips, Jermaine also plays at homeless encampments across the city, where he rarely makes a cent.
I always play something that makes me feel something. Because if I don't feel it, nobody else is going to feel it.
But by playing his saxophone,
I feel like the people who need to hear music the most are those who are going through something.
He hopes he's paying it forward.
People who are struggling with mental health will see that if you have mental health and you get help, you can actually enjoy your life. And you don't have to, it doesn't always have to be clouds and thunderstorms all the time, you know?
And even on the days when his change cup is overflowing, the real payback comes in the form of compliments.
I can't count on my fingers and toes in one day how many people come up to me and they say, thank you so much for what you're doing. We need this so bad.
Because you can find a musician in Music City just about anywhere. But it is rare when you find a one-man ministry.
The fact that I get to bless people doing something that brings me joy and stress relief, I can't ask for anything better.
with photojournalist Jordan Powell, Chris Davis, News Channel 5.
Such a beautiful story. If you or someone you know is struggling with mental health, we want you to know there is help out there. Here's a number to start with, 855-CRISIS-1.
An incredible story.